Good morning, my dear students. Today in this session, we will start with English, first language. Unit 3, name of the unit is sports. You will see over here different types of games given. I will explain you. But first, the poem is given. Poet is Esther Samuel. It is written by Esther Samuel. Name of the poem is Dreams. What do you mean by dream? You all dream when you sleep at night. Many times you get good dreams, many times you get bad dreams. Now let's see. Dreams. Dreams of people, dreams of trees, dreams of lands and dreams of seas. Dreams to grow big, dreams to grow rich, dreams to prosper and dreams of peace. Yes, you can get any type of dreams. Dreams of the country and its growth, dreams of love and dreams of hope. Dreams that all the dreams come true. It's not necessary that all the dreams come true, but we hope that if it is a good dream that it should come true. And we all have some of the other aims in our life. We get dreams that I should be like this, I should have been like this, I need these things in my life. So we dream for that and we hope that our dreams come true. Now here you can see over here the games which often confuse us. Study the information given below. You can see over the pictures of karate and our given games. This is the game taekwondo. It is a modern martial art. Characterized by fast, high and spinning kicks. Taekwondo means the art of kicking and punching, or the art of unarmed combat, means without using your arms, with the legs you have to kick. The sport originated in Korea and is one of the most popular modern martial arts. Here you can see they are hitting by the legs, they are kicking, not by the arms. Now, next game is of karate. It is the hard form of martial art of Japanese origin. It is a striking art using punching, kicking, knee and elbow strikes on the opponent's body. Karate practitioner is called a karateka. Now, next game is judo. You can see over here, the picture is given how they are playing judo. Judo is a gentle form of martial art, again of Japanese origin. Its most prominent feature is the competitive element, where the objective is to throw an opponent to the ground and immobilize or subdue an opponent. Now, have you heard or read something about disability sports? Read detail of such sports. I will explain you over here. While sports has value in everyone's life, it is even more important in the life of a person with a disability, those who are disabled. This is because of rehabilitative influence sport can have not only on the physical body but also in rehabilitating people with a disability into society. Furthermore, sports teaches independence. Nowadays, people with a disability participate in high performance as well as in a competitive and recreational sports also. The number of people with disabilities involved in sport and physical recreation is steadily increasing around the world, with organized sports for athletes with disabilities divided into three main disability groups. That is, sports for the deaf, one who cannot listen. Sports for the person with physical disabilities, means one who is handicapped with the hands or legs. And the sports for the person with intellectual disabilities. From the late 1980s, organizations began to include athletes with disabilities in sporting events such as Olympic Games and Commonwealth Games. However, many sports are practiced by persons with the disability outside the formal sports movements. For example, व्हीलचेयर बास्केटबॉल, व्हीलचेयर डांसिंग, वेट लिफ्टिंग, स्विमिंग एंड मैनी अदर स्पोर्टिंग एक्टिविटीज़ यू कैन जॉइन इफ़ यू आर मेंटली और फिजिकली डिसेबल्ड. You can see over here scuba diving. This is a picture of scuba diving. Now, scuba diving experience. Some people are scared to try scuba dive. Some people love this sport and always find their excuses to go somewhere only to dive. Is this sport has some similarities with my favorite fruit, durian? Either you love or you hate it or just don't have the courage to try. I'd been keep thinking to take a course on scuba dive months ago but wasn't sure as I am scared of snakes, sea snakes. Thinking about it makes me sick and all frightened. Now author says that I am afraid of doing scuba diving because of snakes. But then I was so curious why people loved it so much. They all say that under the sea is like a totally different world, yet a beautiful one. And for that I am taking my risk and try to overcome my fear of the possibility of bumping into a sea snake. So after taking a private lesson from my diving instructor, I went to an island. Here is my first experience, first dive 12 meters depth, tried hard not to panic, what the hell I am doing. I said to myself, what if something had bad happened, but I kept a positive thought. It's going to be a wonderful experience, just do it. Then I sinked myself and went down deeper and deeper. I could feel my heartbeats fast and my ears hurt as I went deeper. Following my diving instructor, I equalized my ears often until I felt comfortable to explore the underwater sea. Suddenly, all around me was green. It felt like living in a green world. Really, as far as I could see, everything was green. I saw some corals, big ones. Some of them looked like giant mushrooms. I saw some sea urchins too, and lot of fish hiding in the sand, enjoying the scenery all around me until my instructor waved at me with her hand holding a pink fin. What, that fin looks familiar, I thought, and yes, that's my fin. Ha ha ha. I didn't realize that my right fin managed to release itself from my right foot. I was almost choked from laughing with the regulator on and the mask attached on my face. So that was the first dive. In total, we dove 5 minutes and 2 days. Five times in a 2 days, sorry. Managed to dive up to 18 meters depth. The next dives were smooth and for sure I didn't lose my fin. Was so happy to see different types of fish swimming in front of me as if I was invisible. The sea definitely looks beautiful underwater and it's really amazed me to realize that there are thousands of creatures living under the sea peacefully. It was indeed so peaceful down there, so quiet. All I could hear was only my breath, breathing in, breathing out, while enjoying the green world and its inhabitants around me. You can see over here, so many fishes are there, orange color, black color, green mushrooms are there. Scuba diving is been done by him. Now next is archery sports. History of archery in India dates back in Vedic era. You are familiar with the mythological character Eklavya. Given here is the beginning of the story. You can see over here the picture of Eklavya. This is the story of long gone era in the country of India. Nearly 5000 years back lived a boy named Eklavya, the son of a tribal chief in the forest of the kingdom Hastinapur. Eklavya was a brave and handsome boy. He was loved by all, but he was not happy. His father saw that something troubled Eklavya. More than once he found his son lost deep in thought. When other boys enjoyed the pleasures of hunting and playing, one day the father, "Here is my Guru Dakshina, Drona," Eklavya said. "I am happy that you have made me your disciple, even if I am a mere Shudra hunter." The sage was humble. He blessed the young archer for his courage. "Eklavya, even without your thumb, you will be known as a great archer. I bless you that you will be remembered forever for your loyalty to your Guru," Drona declared and left the forest. He was moved and grieved at his own action, but he was content that his promise to Arjuna was not broken. The gods blessed Eklavya from above. But despite his handicap, Eklavya continued to practice archery. How could he do so when one is dedicated? One can make even mountains bow. With practice, Eklavya could shoot arrows with his index and middle finger, and he became a greater archer than he was ever before. His renown spread far and wide. When Drona came to know this, he blessed the boy silently and begged for divine forgiveness. Guru Drona was jealous of him, that he will be more cleverer than Arjun. So what he asked his right hand thumb as a Guru Dakshina, and Eklavya happily gave his right thumb as Guru Dakshina. And now without thumb, he again started practicing archery, and again he was successfully able to do archery without the thumb. And Guru Drona came to know all these things. Inner part, he blessed him and begged for his forgiveness, said, "My goodness, what great mistake I have done with this my student." And true to Drona's blessing, Eklavya is still praised as the most loyal and the brave student in the epic of Mahabharata. Still he is known as a loyal and brave student in the Mahabharata. Now, Sachin Tendulkar, sports person, he is also a modern sports person. Sachin Tendulkar is probably the most famous and popular sportsman in India. He has become a public figure but has managed to maintain a dignified, mature outlook, remaining aware of his responsibilities while protecting his privacy. When he married Anjali, a doctor and friend from his childhood, he rejected large sums from satellite TV for a live coverage, keeping it a family affair. He knows his worth, and over the next few years his endorsements are worth $75 million, but he is not a grabber. His father, who was a university professor, taught him a sense of work ethics. Sachin Tendulkar was born in Mumbai on 24th April 1973. You can see over here the picture is given, little master Sachin Tendulkar. In school at Shardashram Vidya Mandir, he got an opportunity to bat for hours in a competition for under 17 Harry's Memorial Challenge Shield. He scored his first century for the school at the age of 12, and since then there was no looking back. He was 16 years and 205 days old when he made his test debut in November 1989 in the National Stadium in Karachi. The very next year, he hit his first test century at Old Trafford, Manchester, England. This century was an example of an exercise in technique, concentration and application beyond his tender age. and it saved a match being lost. Had it come 31 days earlier, he would have been the youngest century maker in the test history. In 1991-92, he went to Australia, where they still talk in awe of his centuries scored in Perth and Sydney. You saw, children, here that different types of sports are given. Nowadays, always you are playing with the mobile games. So children, please see that you flourish in this such type of games. You should play such type of sports and develop your career.